Good morning, students. I hope you and your family members all are healthy. So let's start the chapter number 2 again. In my previous video, I was explained up to high level language. Now in this video, let's start from the high level language. So high level language will split into three parts: procedural language, non-procedural language, and natural language. So now let's start with the first language, that is a high level language. So high level languages used English languages for instructions, simple English languages for instruction, and it is a very user friendly and easier to understand. High level language is machine independent language. Machine independent means programs are portable to other computer. I again repeat, machine independent means programs are portable to other computer. The next is interpreter and compiler are the two programs used to translate high level languages into machine languages so that the computer can understand it. See here, interpreter and compiler are the two programs. They will convert the high level languages content into the machine language in zeros and one language. So next, again, high level language is divided into three parts: procedural, non-procedural, and natural language. So let's start with the first topic, procedural language. So these are the three points. Now next is, the programmer write instructions that tells the computer what to complete and how to do it. I again repeat, what to complete and how to do it. Next, they again use the compiler and interpret two programs to convert the language into machine language. And the examples are C language, Basic, Pascal, and Fortran. These are the examples of this language. Now, the next is non-procedural language. It is also called a third generation language, that is a 3GL and source program. The programmer only specifies what the program should complete without explaining how. I again repeat, specifies what the programmer should accomplish without explaining how. But in a procedural language, need to explain both what to complete and how to do it. But in non-procedural language, only need to explain accomplish without explaining how. Next, uses English language, English statements like a procedural language. Again, they uses the compiler and interpreter two programs to convert this language into machine language. And the examples are Visual Basic, Oracle, Java, etc. Now, the next is natural language. It is also called a fifth generation language. The user to enter requests that resemble human speech. Like no need to type anything, no need to use any other language, only the human speech. Next, these languages are often associated with expert system and artificial intelligence like robots. These systems are popular in the medical field. So in medical field, generally we use the fifth generation languages, in artificial intelligence also. So next topic is language processor. Language processor is a software. It will convert a source program into a machine language. So there are the two programs, compiler and interpreter. So compiler convert the entire high level program into machine language at once, and also display error for the whole program together. Next, interpreter, it convert one line of program at a time. It display the error one line at a time and goes to the next line only after correction of that error. I again repeat, see this diagram. In this diagram, first is compiler and second is interpreter. So in compiler, it convert the entire high level program into machine language at once. Also display error for the whole program together. But in interpreter also convert high level language into machine language. It convert one line of a program at a time and display the error one line at a time and goes to the next line only after correction of that error. So this is the main difference between the compiler and interpreter, but they both are the programs for conversion, to converge one language to other language, like a high level language to machine language. So there are so many languages used in computer, like C, C++, Pascal, Ruby. So many languages are there. So let's see some other high-level languages are. So first is BASIC. It stands for the beginner all purpose symbolic instruction code. It is a programming language used by beginners. Second is COBOL. It stands common business oriented languages. This language is specially designed for business applications. Third is FORTRAN. It stands for formula translation. It is one of the oldest high level language. This language was designed to solve scientific problems. Next is Java. It is an object oriented programming language. We also call it as a OOP. Developed by Sun Microsystems. Next is C and C++. They are the most widely used languages for developing commercial software applications. Next is Visual Basic. Based on the basic programming language which is developed by Microsoft. We already heard this word Microsoft, like window in Windows. Next is Delphi. It is a powerful program development tool used for building web applications. So next is Prolog. Prolog means programming logic. It is used for developing of artificial intelligence applications. So next is HTML. That is a hypertext markup language. It is a special formatting language used to format document for displaying on web. Web means on internet. So JavaScript, it is an interpreted language that allow a programmer to add dynamic content to a web page, any dynamic content. So these are the some other high level languages. So in next video, we will start to do the question answer and book exercises. So please read this chapter again and try to understand the difficult words and difficult content. And each and every topic. This is your homework. So let's we start the question answer and book exercise in next video. Thank you.